And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. If iniquity shall abound, is there no provision of an assured and continued victory? This was the focus of the 2019 Believers Retreat, themed The Power and the Victory of the Cross, which was held at Potter's House Christian Mission, Bedford, Alata Village, Adebayo Idianire, Ibadan. God bless you.
Lord, there is something you want to do to whosoever believeth. The promise is ever true. Because it has been tried many times. It has been found to be ever true. Lord, as we kickstart this meeting, please start us off. Release your word to us tonight. Cause it to come to us. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Permit me to quickly welcome you. Even though tomorrow I think the Lord will give us space to welcome you properly. This opening night permits me to welcome you from different towns and different states of this country. We are glad that the Lord brought you. And we celebrate your coming. However, it is needful for me to tell you that it is not going to be business as usual. Our hearts are full of expectation. We're trusting God to throw us into a realm that we have never stepped before. I am not going to tell you that we are well prepared. But irrespective of our ill preparation, yet the Lord has a promise. And we believe his promise. I'm going to share a burden as a charge. I'm going to share a point of decision with you as a charge. And I will leave you to decide. And you will leave me to decide. And to pursue whatever becomes our decision. Permit me to read unto you 2 Kings chapter 15. And I'm going to read verses actually. I shouldn't read many verses. But let me read verses 13 to 18. Verse 18 is all that I need for this brief burden, for this brief charge. 2 Kings chapter number 15. And I'm reading verses 13 to 18. Shalom, the son of Jabez, began to reign in the 39th year of Uzziah, king of Judah, and he reigned a full month in Samaria.
Salomon oma Jabesh bere si joba le odun 19 Uzziah oba Judah o si joba osu kan gbako ni Samaria.
For Menahem the son of Gadi went up from Tarza and came to Samaria and smote Shalom the son of Jabesh in Samaria and slew him and reigned in his stead.
Nitori ti Menahemu omo Gadi goke lati ti salo o si wa si Samaria o si kolu Salomo omo Jabesh ni Samaria o si pa o si joba ni ipo re.
And the rest of the acts of Shalom and his conspiracies which he made, behold, they are written in the book of the Chronicles of the Kings of Israel.
Ati yoku ise Salomo ati rikisi re ti o di kiesi ako won sinu iwe oro ojo awon oba Israeli.
Then Menahem smote Tibsah and all that were therein, and the coast thereof from Tarza, because they opened not to him, therefore he smote it, and all the women therein that were with child, he ripped up.
Nigba na ni Menahem kolu Tisfa ati gbogbo tin be ninu re ati ile agbegbe re won ni lati Tisa lo nitori ti won ko si sile fun nitori na lo se kolu ati gbogbo awon obirin aboyun inu o la ni inu.
In the 39th year of Azariah king of Judah began Menahem the son of Gadi to reign over Israel and reigned 10 years in Samaria.
Le odu kokandilogun Azariah oba Judah ni Menahem omo Gadi bere si joba lori Israeli o si joba odun mewa ni Samaria.
And he did that which was evil in the sight of the Lord. He departed not all his days from the sins of Jeroboam the son of Nebat, who made Israel to sin.
O si se eyi ti o buru le oju Oluwa o ko si kuro ninu ese Jeroboam omo Nebati eni ti o mu Israel se le ojo re gbogbo.
May the Lord bless this word in our hearts in the name of Jesus.
Ki Olorun ko bukun ore ni okan wa ni oruko Jesu.
I am hoping to just bring a very brief charge to you.
Mo nireti lati mu oro akoso kukuru wa toyin wa.
Except for the little delay we had with electricity, by now this meeting should have been over.
Bi ki ba se idaduro die ta ni nipa ina monomono abati mu oro wa saju akoko yi.
Ipade
ba ti pari.
However,
bakan na
we have gathered for this reason.
Ati kora wa jopo fun idi yi,
and we cannot, for the delay we experience, throw away the reason for which we have gathered.
Asi le tori n to sele yi ka wa so idi ati eridi ta fi kora wa jopo.
I am not bringing you something that is difficult to explain.
Ki se on to nira lati salaye oni mo mu to wa wa.
I told you it's a burden in my heart.
Mo so fun pe o je edun okan ninu okan mi.
I told you it's a point of decision for me.
O je ibi ipinu fun mi.
Ikorita
ipinu fun mi.
And I want to share this with you as a charge.
Mo si fe pin papo pelu yin pelu oro akoso yi.
As we kick start this meeting.
Bi ati bere pade yi.
Possibly it can become a burden in your own heart.
To ba se elele di edun okan re pelu.
And a matter to pray about.
Ati oran ta gbadura si.
And you may also find it a point of decision.
Wona si le ri gege bi ikorita ipinu.
Shalom the son of Jabesh,
Salomo omo Jabesi,
was reigning over Israel.
O njoba lori Israeli.
That I have no business with him.
Ko si nkan to kan mi pelu eleyi.
So I'm not going to talk about it.
Mo ni soro nipa eleyi.
But suddenly,
sugbon lojiji,
Menahem, the man I want to talk about,
okunrin ti mo fe so nipa re yi,
rose from Tarza.
O dide lati Tarza
and went as far as Samaria.
O si lo titi de Samaria
and he smote Shalom.
O si kolu Salomo
And the Bible said, and he slew him.
Bibeli so pe o si pa.
And he reigned in his stead.
O si joba ni ipo re.
As young as I am,
bi mo se kere mo yi,
I witnessed few coup d'etat in Nigeria.
Mo ti ri orisiriri orisirisi ditegbajoba ni orilede yi.
In those days of military era,
ni akoko isijoba awon omo ologun,
some could be very bloody.
Omi o le mu itaje sile to po dani,
and some may not be bloody.
Omi si le mu itaje sile lowo.
Only few were bloodless.
Awon ti o awon die ninu won ni o mu itaje sile dani.
But most times,
sugbon ni opo igba,
when a coup is like that staged,
nigba ti a ba dite bi eleyi,
sometime and many times,
ni opo igba mi abi ni opolopo igba,
it is because there is a dissatisfaction with the government in power.
O ma sele nitori pe aini telorun pelu ijoba to nbe lori alefa lo fa.
But we know sometime it could be because of greed.
Igba mi o si le je nitori iwa oju kokoro,
because of love for power.
Nigbami o le je nitori ife nini ife si agbara.
And so such conspiracies could arise, you know, at different location for different reasons.
Awon iru ote bayi tabi idite bayi o le dide nitori idi ati nitori awon nkan orisirisi.
I told you that I have no business with Shallum.
Mo so fun pe won ni kankan se pelu Shallum.
But this man Menahem,
sugbo okunrin yi tan pe ni Menahem,
who came to Samaria,
e to wa si Samaria,
and killed the king,
to si pa oba,
I felt
mo wo pe
he must have scored the king very low.
Ogbodo ti le so pe obo o se nkan kan to da rara.
The king must have performed very low.
Oba ma o ti le ogboro ti se nkan ti o ti e ti o to nkan rara.
And so he had come to correct the ills.
O wa wa lati wa se atunse sin ti o da.
And so he toppled the government.
O wa doju ijoba re de.
And he took over power.
O si gba agbara lowo re.
He sat on the throne.
O si joko ni ori ite.
But verse 18 tells me,
ese ikejidilogun wa so fun mi pe,
that he did that which is evil in the sight of the Lord.
Pe o si se yi ti o buru ni oju Oluwa.
And that was what his predecessor did.
O na ni en to gba ijoba lowo re na se.
And he did not depart all his days.
O ko si kuro ni gbogbo ojo re.
From the sin of Jeroboam.
Kuro ninu ese Jeroboam.
The son of Nebat.
Omo Nebati.
Which he made Israel to sin.
Eto mu ki seli ko se.
As I tried to round off,
bi mo se ngbiyanju lati kojo,
like I told you, it's going to be a short charge.
Mo so fun pe yo je oro.
My challenge is,
ipenileja mi ni pe,
what is the use,
kini anfani,
of killing Shallum,
bi pa to pa Shallum,
when he himself
nigba ti o nti kalara
re no do anything better than Shallum,
si ko ni se nkan to ni lari ju Shallum lo.
Why will he come to power,
e ti se ti o se wa gba ipo agbara,
if he's not going to do anything different,
si o ba ni se nkan to yato
from what the man who is there was doing,
yato si nkan ti okunrin to wa nbe tele nse.
Every time
gbogbo igba,
somebody comes into prominence,
ene kan yo wa sibi to gbaju gbaja,
when somebody comes into prominence,
nigba ti ene kan ba wa si igbagede,
if you check very well,
te ba wo da,
he must have displaced somebody.
Ogbodo lati mu ene kan ye ba kuro nbe.
I read about one particular beast in the book of Daniel.
Eranko kan ninu iwe Daniel.
With about 10 horns.
Pelu to ni iwo mewa.
And suddenly there was a horn that grew up.
Lojiji iwo kan be to ra to re dide.
And displayed about 2 or 3 horns.
O si mu ki awon iwo meji meta ko kuro nibi ti won wa.
For it to get a space.
Fun lati gbe ri aye joko.
Every time a ministry springs up,
igbakugba ti e ba ri ile ise iranse kan to di
bele, if it's a correct ministry,
to ba je ile ise iranse to da,
it must be that God is dissatisfied with a ministry.
O gbodo je pe inu Olorun o dun si ile ise iranse kan.
Every time a minister rises,
igbakugba ti iranse Olorun kan ba dide,
and he is a correct servant of God,
to ba si je iranse Olorun to,
it must be because God wants to displace another one. Many times when God raises a man, many times when God raises a meeting, and he pulls people to that meeting, it must be that he is dissatisfied with one meeting somewhere. The question I have asked God, that I have asked God, that I will still ask him, is that, is there a need for Believers Retreat
2019?
Is there a need for Potter's House Christian Mission? Is there a need for Brashegun Ariyo to continue in ministry?
Is there a need for Arakunrin
if all that I will do is to repeat the errors of the past, then let that error continue. There is nothing I'm looking for, therefore. If this meeting is simply going to be like any other meeting, then there is no need for this meeting. The challenge in my heart is, oh God, will you gather your people by your own hand, and yet it will be like any other meeting. And I told God, if that is what is going to happen, then cancel this meeting. Don't let it be. If he has not canceled this meeting, and he has brought you, then I want to set my heart that it must not be business as usual. My trust tonight is that, will you come again and go the same way? Will you walk again in the path of Jeroboam, the son of Nebat? What God is dissatisfied with, is that what you are going to repeat?
So
tonight, it's a burden in my heart. It's a point of decision that this meeting must not be like any other meeting in my own life. I must not come here as a struggler, and I will leave this meeting as a struggler. I must not come here as a defeated Christian, so to speak, and I will leave here defeated. No. I am totally in disagreement with that. So tonight, as we are going to pray, your decision and my decision may not be the same. If there is nothing else to pick, if there is nothing special to take, if God is not going to do something critical in your life, there is no point staying here. We're praying the night here, stroke this morning. And I told the brethren, do you think it is right for us to call people to sleep under this situation? And yet nothing will happen to them. I will not come here and live the same. I don't know what your thoughts are. But tonight, I want you to come to that point of deciding. The Lord, something new must happen to me in this meeting. We're going to study the word of God. We're going to be praying together. God has given us a glimpse of what he's going to do. And I know he is never a deceiver. When he's not ready to do anything, he doesn't venture into it. I am persuaded in my heart that this meeting will be according to your faith. This meeting will be according to your decision. This meeting to you will be according to the desire of your heart. So you need to come to that point. This man travel, risk his life. Wasted lives. The city that did not support him. He went there, destroyed them. Pregnant women were ripped. Destroyed the mother, destroyed the fetus. The killing was so much. And yet, for no reason. And I ask, why will you go that far? Just to have a name in power? Just to have a taste of power? Just destroying people? Think about how much you have spent to come here. Think about the condition under which you are going to sleep here. There is nothing enticing here. It takes strong decision to come here. And yet will you pay such sacrifices for no reason? Stand to your feet. Let's pray. There is a blessed invitation to whosoever believeth. Brother, it means you. This meeting is for you, and it's for me. If you believe. But the fact that you believe is not all it takes. There must be a decision of the heart. David said, I have made up my mind to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. It's a decision. To die is a choice. To live is a choice. You must choose to have a different experience in this meeting. If what God did in your life last year is what he's going to do now, there's no point being in this meeting. If what God did when you came here for December retreat is what he's going to repeat, I tell you, there is no reason for you to be in this meeting. If you move for hours only to find yourself on the same spot, there is no reason wasting your sweat. There must be a moving forward. There must be an indelible impact. You have been struggling with sin for years. It is time to experience the power and the victory of the cross. You have been hearing it for long. It is time for you to experience it. It's a choice. It's a decision. If you come here and you are saying, I just want to enjoy that brother, I just love to listen to him.
O man fe lati feti si arakunrin.
I like the way he speaks.
O se man soro e man wu mi.
That will be very disastrous.
Eleyi yo je nkan to buru jai.
If it is not that you have a target, and yet you have come this far, then you are a waster of divine resources. You cannot have come this far without a focus, without a decision, without something tangible in your heart that must come into your hand. Your decision must be firm. Don't come here because you want to have a taste of the meeting. See, I used to hear they hold a meeting during Easter. Let me go and taste and see. Don't come and taste and see. Don't come only to register the registration stand. I learned they used to send some messages to people. Let me also go and register my name. That will be too cheap for you, brother. There is something better that you can do with your time than to come here to do just that. My challenge this night is not to preach, is to recondition your heart, is to recondition your expectation over this meeting. This man destroy lives. Who knows how many people God blocked for you to be here? I don't know if you know how much has been put into this meeting just for you to be here. Will you therefore come just to register your name and have a taste of the meeting and go back the same way, or even go back worse? The Bible said all the days of his life he did not depart from the sin of Jeroboam. All the days of his life, all the days of his life, he did evil. He continued in evil. And he died in evil. His record of evil is still there. All the days of his life, he had opportunity to make a difference, but he blew it. He had opportunity to do something differently, but he wasted it.
If what will happen in my life, if what will happen to my life is what I've been seeing, then it doesn't work. Lord Jesus, I simply ask you that this meeting must move me forward. It must be a major turning point in my life. Lord Jesus, I plead with you that this meeting will settle these cases that I have to present before you. Let it be the point of breaking forth for me in the name of Jesus.
The flood is not saying it will not collapse the building. It is the owner of the building that will not tolerate it. The flood is not saying it will not pull down the house. It is the owner of the building that will not tolerate it.
Bring this prayer point to close. I wish we can pray more. But I heard the Lord say, it's enough now. So I'm going to stop here. Lord Jesus, I am praying. We don't want to repeat history. In this meeting. I have read in the Bible. And so person. Live so number of years. And begat sons and daughters. And he died. And the next one. Live so number of years. Begat sons and daughters. And he died. They kept repeating history. Until Enoch. A man who decided to have a different record.
And
Enoch walked with God. Lord Jesus.
Yes, Oluwa.
I am praying. That this meeting. Will be a different meeting. Lord,
Oluwa,
in our lives,
ninu aye wa,
and in the life of this ministry,
ati ninu aye ilese iranse yi,
in our lives,
ninu aye wa,
and in the life of Nigeria,
ati ninu orilede Nigeria,
let this meeting be a different meeting in the name of Jesus.
Je ki ipade yi je ipade to yato gedegede ni
oruko Jesu. As we go to take our rest,
Oluwa ba o se lo simi bayi,
I am pleading with you.
Nse ni mo nbe o,
that even on our beds,
pe lori ibusun wa,
wherever we choose to sleep,
nibi kibi ta ba yan lati sun,
let it come back to
Oluwa
us.
Oluwa je ko pada to wa wa o,
that this means you.
Pe etun oni.
This means you. This means you. This is what defines you. This is what shows the direction you will go in this meeting. Father, help our unbelief in the name of Jesus. I plead with you tonight that nobody will make the sacrifice of coming here and yet return empty. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, I have prayed. I have prayed.